Blackstone Audio presents I Dared to Call Him Father, The Miraculous Story of a Muslim Woman's Encounter with God, by Bilquis Sheikh, with Richard H. Schneider. This book is read by Lorna Raver. To my grandson, Mahmoud, my little prayer partner, who has been a source of joy and comfort to me through many lonely hours. 1. A Frightening Presence. The strange, prickly feeling grew inside me as I walked slowly along the graveled paths of my garden. It was deep twilight. The scent of early narcissus hung heavy in the air. What was it, I wondered, that made me so uneasy? I stopped my walk and looked around. Inside my home, some distance across the broad lawn, the servants were beginning to flick on lights in the dining area. Outside, all seemed peaceful and quiet. I reached out to snip off some of the pungent white blossoms for my bedroom. As I leaned over to grasp the tall green stems, something brushed past my head. I straightened in alarm. What was it? A mist-like cloud, a cold, damp, unholy presence had floated by. The garden suddenly seemed darker. A chilling breeze sprang up through the weeping willows, and I shivered. "Get hold of yourself, Bilquis," I scolded. My imagination was playing tricks on me. Nevertheless, I gathered my flowers and headed quickly toward the house, where windows glowed in warm reassurance. Its sturdy white walls and wooden doors offered protection. As I hurried along the crunchy gravel path, I found myself glancing over my shoulder. I had always laughed at talk of the supernatural. Of course, there wasn't anything out there. Was there? As if in answer, I felt a firm, very real, and uncanny tap on my right hand. I screamed. I rushed into the house and slammed the door behind me. My servants ran to me, afraid to make any comment at all, for I must have looked like a ghost myself. It wasn't until bedtime that I finally found the courage to speak to my two maids about the cold presence. "Do you believe in spiritual things?" I asked on concluding my story. Both Nurjan and Raisham, one a Muslim, the other a Christian, avoided answering my question. But Nurjan, her hands fluttering nervously, asked me if she could call the village mullah, a priest from the mosque, who would bring some holy water to cleanse the garden. But my common sense had returned, and I rebelled at submitting to the superstition of the ignorant. Besides, I didn't want any word of this to spread in the village. I tried to smile at her concern and told her, a little too abruptly, I'm afraid, that I didn't want any holy man on my grounds pretending to remove evil spirits. Nevertheless, after the maids left the room, I found myself picking up my copy of the Quran. But after struggling through a few pages of the Muslim holy book, I wearied of it, slipped it back within its blue silken case, and fell asleep. I awakened slowly the next morning, like a swimmer struggling to the surface, a thin, high chant piercing my consciousness. La ilaha illa illah. Muhammad Resulullah. The sing-song words drifted through my bedroom window. There is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his prophet. It was a comforting sound, this Muslim call to prayer, because it seemed so utterly normal after the previous night. It was a call I had heard almost without exception every morning of my 54 years. I envisioned the source of the rolling chant. Some moments before, in the little nearby Pakistani village of Va, our old muezzin had hurried through the door at the base of an ancient minaret. Inside its cool interior, he had trudged up curving stone steps worn smooth by the sandals of generations of Muslim holy men. At the top of the prayer tower, I could imagine him hesitating at the carved teak door leading to the parapet to catch his breath. Then, stepping outside to the railing, he threw back his bearded head and in syllables 1,400 years old called the faithful to prayer. Come to prayer, come to salvation. Prayer is better than sleep. The haunting cry floating through the morning mist across cobblestone lanes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.